At least 156 people have died in the tragic Halloween stampede in a popular nightlife district of the South Korean capital, Seoul. Most of the victims were in their 20s, and there were more women among the dead than men. Domestic experts and legislators are urging the Ministry of Interior to put forth safety management guidelines as soon as possible for large-scale gatherings without official event organizers.
South Korea's mask ban was lifted and people took to the streets to celebrate Halloween. Unexpectedly, a shoving incident broke out, killing 156 people. The stampede in Itaewon, South Korea, shocked the world. Taiwan's current regulations only regulate the event organizers, but should complement the safety management plan for large-scale events without organizers. There have been large crowd gathering accidents in Taiwan. On New Year's Eve in 2004, a large number of people flocked to the Taipei MRT. Five people were injured, and two people suffered lacerations to their scalps due to the escalator's high speed. Later in 2016, a similar accident occurred at New Taipei's Christmas Land event. As crowds poured into the train station, it was suspected the escalator was overwhelmed and fell nearly 3 meters, causing people to fall and injure their heads. Relevant ministries said they would conduct a rolling review as soon as possible in response to legislators' call to put forward guidelines for safety management at large-scale gatherings without organizers.
属于自主的，那当然是没有办法说预期说它人数有多少，相对它的疏散的动线也就不会有预先的规划了。我们会去做一些探讨。如果是突发性的这种人潮聚集，譬如说我们河湾山下雪，南投县仁爱分局他们也非常激烈，他们都有既定的交委计划。Experts
and legislators have reminded the authorities that Christmas and New Year's Eve events will be celebrated at the end of the year. Using Itaewon stampede as an example, it is particularly important to prevent crowding accidents in advance.